I'd now like to ask Professor Dimitri Kitsikis of the University of Ottawa to come forward.
Yes, you're probably curious to try to understand how a Christian Orthodox, a Greek Christian Orthodox, could be part of the Gülen movement. I'm sure you are curious to know. And even a few days ago, in Athens, coming from Athens, the Society of Greek Benefactors gave me an award that they put the award on it for Homo Hellenicus, you know, Homo Hellenicus, for spreading Hellenism all over the world. Imagine. So, well, what's the answer? My very good friend, peace be on him, President Turgut Özal, when I met him for the first time, we went to pray together on the tomb of Haji Bektash. I understood through him how much he loved Bektashi Alevis. And as already before that, I was very much influenced by Bektashism, we prayed together on the tomb of Haji Bektash, and then, you know, we wrote together his famous book in French, because you know I'm French too, Turkey in Europe. And so I entered the movement through the Abant Forum. This is how I started, the Abant Forum. And after a certain while, I thought that, I saw it, that the people that were on Abant Forum had also a relation with the Gülen movement. So this is how I came to the Gülen movement. Now, how do I appreciate the work of Fethullah Gülen? For me, I'm a fanatical of the recreation of the Ottoman Empire. I have given all my life to publicize the idea of recreating the most tolerant, the most perfect multi-religious, not multinational, multi-religious society that it was the Ottoman Empire. It's the only place in the world, and I give it as a model to the world, that all these millet people, they lived in harmony, in complete tolerance, and this is what Gülen is. The first word of Gülen is tolerance. To accept the different religious communities, and I can say that these communities have to live together, but be different, not new age, not, you don't mix up all religions. You have to stay what you are. If you're Sunni, you have to be a Sunni. If I'm a Greek Orthodox, I have to keep a Greek Orthodox, not mixing up. It's completely divine. At the beginning, I was a little bit afraid. I thought that the Gülen movement was perhaps kind of new age, you know, and I hate mixing up things, you know, because I like Chinese food, I like Turkish food. So if you mix up Chinese food and Turkish food, well, then it's, you can't eat it, it's horrible. Imagine if you put together the Sunnis, the Shiites, the Alevis, the Orthodox, the Catholic, it's incredible. Doesn't make any sense. You have to be yourself, you see, and marry within your community. I married a woman that is Greek Orthodox. I love Turkish girls, you know why? But they said, no, it's a mistake, don't marry a Turkish Muslim. But I said, they're so beautiful. They said, no, you have to marry in your community, you see. So, this is how I came, and I recommend you this wonderful tolerance and sincerity. Some people said that. You have to be sincere, like a child. You mustn't hide anything. This is real love. And I learned that from the Bektashi Alevis too. You know, the word love is the most important thing in the world. Thank you very much.